I come from a religious background, like a super religious background. I was raised Assemblies of God, which is, oh, yeah. It's just like the church in Game of Thrones that throws feces at people while yelling shame. But with more macaroni salad and Rascal Scooters. So I have had three baptisms and two exorcisms. I was never actually possessed by the devil. I was just a woman in the South with an opinion, and that needs to be stopped. And people ask me, they'll be like, "Hey, Liz, you've had an exorcism? Like, how does something like that, like, how does that even happen, man?" And I'll be like, "Well, for one of them, my mom told me to put on my best dress because we're going to IHOP. I should have known it was a trap." Nobody puts on their best dress to go to IHOP. Nobody even wears pants to IHOP. Plus, we didn't actually even go to IHOP. Instead, she drove us to this trailer park faith healing commune, and I never got my Rooty Tooty fresh and fruity. I did, however, get holy water thrown on me by a guy named Rudy who had a wife named Trudy, but it's not the same thing. Sucks, man. Same thing. Everybody in that whole damn religion is a killjoy, man. Every now and then, they'd have themselves a good old-fashioned book burning. And I understand why they burned my books on werewolves and telekinesis, but what did Nancy Drew ever do to anybody? And I asked my grandpa about it, and he'd be like, "Oh, she's a woman. Doesn't know her place, always poking her nose into man business. You want to read something? How about Hardy Boys? It's a story of two good old-fashioned Christian boys solving crimes. Or Leviticus. You can read all about how women are property and blacks bear the mark of Cain. Leviticus. It's a good read." It's the worst book club ever.